Glory be to God. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. Thank you for sending your words to us, O God. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. So we go into your word now. Please speak to our hearts. Bless us through your words. And at the end of our race, help us to reign with you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I want to appreciate you for listening to us. I want to pray that the Almighty God will bless you in the name of Jesus. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channels and share with others so that we can grow together. The YouTube channel is Timothy Folorunsọ, and the Lord bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. Yes, we want to continue with our series, Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. There is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is the way of death. There is a way that seems right to a man, but its end is the way of death. We've discussed a lot of things on this verse, Bible verse. Please listen to our previous videos. Now, today we want to look at the end of the matter. The end of the matter. This is very crucial because there is nothing that has a beginning without an end. There is nothing here on earth that you start that you will not end one day. It's either you see the end of that thing or that thing see your end. People may not like to hear this, but that is just the truth. There is a way that seems right to a man. You see, what disqualifies that way is not as if it's not only good, but because its end is bad. When you know that something is not going to end well, wisdom demands that you change your style, change the way. There is nothing that has a beginning, I've said that, without an end. And when we say end, end could mean future or reward. According to Proverbs chapter 23, verse 18, Proverbs chapter 23, verse 18 says, "For surely there is an end." Another version says, "For surely there is a future, there is a reward," Amplified version. "And thy expectations shall not be cut off." There is an end. End could also mean outcome or result. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8 says, "Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof." Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. Another version says, "Finishing is better than starting." That's New Living Translation. Finishing is better than starting. Whatever you are doing, we end one day. Any process you start, by default, is supposed to end. If you are writing a program, computer program, if you write at the beginning, you are going to end it. If you don't end it, that program might not be useful. You terminate it, you end it. The programmers listening to me will understand. So, when the end is not going to be favorable, God is always giving guidance to his children. But sometimes that guidance may not make sense to us because we don't know what will happen at the end. There is a way that seems right to a man. We've told you that that man could be you, could be someone else. But the end thereof is the way of death. What disqualifies that way is the end. End could also mean a period of fulfillment. When we say end, it may not mean that when you are going to die. No. It could also mean a period of fulfillment. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3. Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 3 says, "For the vision is yet for an appointed time." It says, "But at the end it shall speak." At the end it shall speak. So, whatever you are, do you have any, maybe you have any vision. Maybe you have any vision with you. There is something that God has revealed to you. There is a end to that thing. At the end, that thing will speak. Or maybe you have a thought in your heart that you've been nursing over time. The end will come. That thought will become a reality, good or bad. Remember the story of Gehazi in the Bible? When the master was ministering to Naaman, go and bathe yourself so that you'll be healed, Gehazi was targeting the words of the man. Secretly within himself. When the master rejected the offer, Gehazi ran after the man and collected it. At the end, he went with leprosy. Whatever you are starting will end one day. If you are doing good, there is an end. If you are doing bad, there is an end. If you are doing nothing, of course, end will also come. So let's always think about this. Are you in one position today? There is an end. Even if you don't leave that position, one day you will retire. You become too old for that position. You will leave the place. So what lesson are we going to learn from this? Knowing that there is an end to everything we are doing, make sure you choose the right way. Let God guide your choice. Make sure what you are doing is pleasant to God and is not harmful to man, because end will come. End will come. There is an end. So we need to think about this. What are you holding on to? Someone might have been holding on to it before your arrival, and you might not be the last person. There is a way that seems right to a man. The end is the way of destruction. The end will come. It may not be that you are going to die. And of course, there is the ultimate end. It is appointed unto man once to die. After that is what? Is judgment. And if you don't die, rapture will come. So end will come. What is that thing you are enjoying today? Some of the things that appeared as enjoyment 50 years, 100 years ago, today to you might be something that you don't even value again. So why not just hold on to God, who has no end? You can't trace his beginning, because he is the beginning and he is the ending. Why not hold out unto him? He's the one that can make you end well. Like Apostle Paul that said, I've fought a good fight. I've finished the race. What will be your testimony when the ultimate end comes? If you have not accepted Jesus, this is an opportunity for you to accept him into your life, because there is an end. The end, if you have opportunity to see the end of what you are about to do, you might not do it. But the scripture is coming to you this time. Hand it over, hand that choice over to God. Oh, this one has offended me. I'm going to sow him. There is an end to that sowing. When the end comes, will you be able to face it? So if you are far away from Christ, he's the only one that can make you to end well. Whatever anyone may be saying, whatever anyone may not be saying, Jesus, your closeness to Jesus will make you to end well. So if you are far away from him, please accept him now. Pray with me and say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and my Savior. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name. The Lord will bless you and you will end well. You will not end in shame. You will not end in disgrace, in the name of Jesus. The Lord will guide your utterances. The Lord will guide your thoughts. The Lord will guide your actions. Your Lord will guide your decisions. The Lord will guide your choices, in the mighty name of Jesus. And you will end well, in the name of Jesus. That which you are doing that seems as if it's right to a man, as if it's right to you, but the end is destruction, the Lord will redirect your path, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. The Lord bless you. If you have been blessed with this sermon, share it with others. Let us grow together, and the Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus. See you next week by God's grace.